In honor of Robert De Niro's birthday on August 17th, I'm counting down with my De Niro movies. So let's pick which one today's watch is. Oh no! Oh, that was a reaction. Okay, so This Boy's Life. I've already done a video on it. Basically, a few videos ago, there was a TikTok stitch going around going, what's your best or worst Father's Day video to watch? It's this one. This one. This is the worst father that you want to encounter. It's a domestic violence story, and it's really uncomfortable and hard to sit through. And it got to the point where I wanted to smack De Niro in the face and be like, you a-hole. Yes. So it's got Leonardo DiCaprio in it, Robert De Niro, and Alan Barkin. It is really intense to watch. It is definitely not everyone's cup of tea. Let me read you the synopsis for those who haven't heard of this story. Based on the true life award-winning book by Tobias Wolff, two free spirits flee an abusive relationship to settle in the hopeful plains of the Pacific Northwest. Instead of the bright future he was promised, Tobias must endure the tyrannical and often brutal rule of his new stepfather, Dwight, and show courage and a will to fight well beyond his years to make the future he has always dreamed of. Look, I'm just saying that if you hate Robert De Niro, this is your movie, because this will make you hate him even more. Whereas if you love Robert De Niro, like I do, I'm so sorry. Your illusion of him will be smashed to smithereens. I love how simple this disc is. Like, at the front we've got the cover, where it looks like a, you know, a problematic family lifestyle. But then you open it up and just, it gives you the idea of what we're about to watch. And this is not a buckle up and smile ride. This is a buckle up and control your emotions ride. I love how this kind of tricks you, because you look at it as like a husband and wife being quite romantic, and then you've got the kid who's kind of just there. So this kid is kind of like, well, maybe they're adopted, maybe they're troublesome. Maybe it's just two parents trying to, you know, control their boy's life onto the right path. And then with a score like that, you know, again, you sit there going, well, it looks like a sweet, wholesome story. Like, he's a troublemaker, the parents are doing right. The score is trying to show how beautiful this film is. But then you watch the film and you're like, ooh, yeah, it's not what I think it is. So let's hit play.
Let's take a boat to Bermuda. Let's take a plane to St. Paul.
Again, it's sucking you into this idea of like, this is going to be a pretty film.
Let's get away from it all. Let's take a trip in a trailer. No need to come back at all. Let's take a powder to Boston for China. Let's get away from it all. We'll travel around from town to town. We'll visit every state. I repeat, I love you, sweet, in all the 48. Let's go again to Niagara.
This time we'll be at the falls. Let's get our hut deep.
It was 1957. We were driving from Florida to Utah.
I think for me, the reason why I kind of hate this film for all the right reasons, and I say for the right reasons because of its storyline, is because I've grown up in a similar situation twice, and as a child it's really scary, and it's not a situation a child deserves to be in. So watching this, there's a reason why I hate Robert De Niro's character, because I'm like, these are guys that I've known in my life, and I don't need that back in my life. Even if it's an actor who I worship, I don't need him to play a character like that. Even if he is acting and doing it to pay the bills, like, I don't need that. But it also shows how common DV is in a lot of lives, regardless of what generation you grew up in, regardless of what type of parents raised you, whether it was your mom or dad. It just goes to show how common this topic is and how hard and uncomfortable it is for everybody to sit through, whether you've experienced it firsthand or not. It's intense. But it's also really interesting because as much as I remember the violent part of this movie, it's really interesting to note that there is some sweet moments, like at the beginning of the film, how Jack and his mom are just on a drive to start a new life. And she's just trying to figure out where to go from point A to B while trying to earn money through this illusion of collecting uranium. You know, so Jack's along for the ride. So it's really interesting to just watch this mother-son dynamic to play out. And then watching the third party come into this scenario and seeing it all just twist and makes you go, I hate this film, but I hate it for all the right reasons.
93!
Yeah! 93
for Perry. Congratulations, Miss Lowe. Real good. Where did you learn to shoot like that?
Beginner's luck, I guess.
Wasn't she good? Wasn't she good, kids? I'm really impressed. My gun, I don't know what happened. Just bolt's not working or something. The third gun I bought just won't work right.
So up until that scene, Dwight's kind of been tiptoeing the line, and that really shows that key moment where he switched on going, I love this woman, but she's not allowed to shut me up. Not just the fact that this is set in like the 50s or whatever, it's the fact that he just got shown up by a woman. He got shown up by his girlfriend. He didn't like that, so he blames his gun. He blames other things, when knowing full well he got the lowest score out of that whole group of shooters, whereas his girlfriend got the highest score. And now the jealousy kicks in, and that's when the tables turn, of when you can see, like, before that scene he kind of took it out on his kids, but you're like, oh well, he's the dad to those three kids, so it makes sense, you know, it's, you leave that situation alone. But then you watch that moment where it's him and Caroline, and it's just that downfall of their relationship, and you start questioning, is it because of the time period? Is it because he's a man? Is it because a woman should know her place? What is it? And then you just watch it bounce along. And it already adds the fact that Tobias slash Jack, because he likes to be called Jack, has already got an issue with the fact that he's trying not to have someone replace his own dad, and already mad at his mom for, like, going from man to man, which is another story in itself. But you can, like, it's just a really interesting dynamic to watch, because you just see it crumble and you sit there questioning so much about everything you know about relationships. I feel like this is the perfect use to use this song.
Smile.
Purely because Toby's losing all of his rights to this guy that he barely knows. And Dwight's just sitting there going, you're doing what I say. And you can just watch the humiliation across Toby's face. That's why I think this song fits in perfectly, because Toby's losing his rights. This is another good scene, because it makes you click how much the mother notices.
You have to try and concentrate on the good stuff. Come on!
That whole scene is brilliant, because it shows that Caroline knows. She knows that her relationship is problematic with Dwight. She knows that she's regretted her life choices in this very moment with Dwight, but there is nothing she can do about it. She's sick of running. She's got nowhere else to go. Her choice is to be homeless with her son or stick it out with Dwight. And just like that whole dialogue, because there is a bigger scene for it, it just shows you how much she's given up and how much she just cannot be the picky in the middle, and it's such an intense moment between mother and son. It's so heartbreaking to watch. So I have to admit that I did stop and take breaks from this movie because fun. But like I said, it's a powerful story. It's hard to sit through at times. It shows a lot in so much time. It shows how powerful a lot of these actors can be. The fact that this was released in 93, the fact that it's set a couple of decades earlier, the fact that it shows you different types of domestic violence. It's not just the beatings, it's not just, you know, leaving you black and blue. It's the mentality that it takes on you. It's the mentality of how it affects other people around you. The mentality of what you don't see and what you don't hear is so much bigger. And it's such a powerful movie. And again, like I said, I highly recommend you watching it. But it is such an intense movie that I feel like only a selection...